Nightcrawler is probably one of the best aspects of X-Men 2. Am I right? Can I get an amen? From poofing into the White House, attacking everyone, oop, too soon. His presence, his introduction was unbelievably amazing, and we want that back in the MCU. So these are my top four actors that I think could play Nightcrawler, Kurt Wagner, in the MCU. This is where the animation would come in with me poofing out, but I don't got that, so I'm just gonna do some really sloppy editing. Ready? Now I'm behind you. Now I'm facing the door. I was fixing my lens and I realized I hit record. I may not keep this, we'll edit this out. Hello one and all, and welcome to another episode of Nerd News. I'm your host, Chris Chavez. And we are back talking about this legendary team, the X-Men, because we are, let's face it, we are all excited that they are coming back to the MCU, coming home to the MCU, and any day now, we're just waiting for just some speckle of news, some just something, Kevin Feige, something. And with so many characters to cover, so many amazing characters that we all know and love, that we read as a kid, that we are rereading as adults, it's hard to pick and choose what characters to talk about. But I saw X-Men 2 a few weeks ago, and I was like, Nightcrawler. I mean, Nightcrawler has been in some of the newer movies as of late, but it just hasn't had that same reaction as the second, the film, as Alan Cummings played that title role. So I wanted to take my stab at it, guys. I wanted to see who I can find, who I can cast in this role and continue that amazing just screen presence that captured our imagination when we saw him way back in the day. But before we poof in today's episode, sorry, I had to. If this is your first time visiting my channel, I would greatly appreciate it if you hit that like, subscribe, and the notification bell. That notification bell will remind you of all future episodes as I post them, and I would greatly appreciate it, guys. Okay, so in no particular order, let's get this bad boy started, shall we? So I'm gonna continue the way that we saw him as of late, a little bit younger. I'm gonna start this off that way, just because I like to see a little bit more content into this character, more of his backstory, and I think that they could really flush him out the way that Marvel does an amazing job at Origins. I mean, this character can go either way. They can cast him old, they can cast him young, they can cast him as a little wee little baby. That'll be weird. I don't think I wanna see him as a baby. But first actor on this list is Robert Sheehan. Now you may recognize Robert from just a small little show and another comic book adaptation, and that of the Umbrella Academy. He plays the quirky character Klaus. Now Robert's ability to capture your attention on screen is amazing. I mean, Klaus is the best character in that show. We can have a debate if you want. Comment below, let's talk about that. Now his energetic personality is palpable when you see him as Klaus. I mean, he knows exactly how to demand just presence on the screen. And not just as Klaus, but he turned his performance down a few notches when he was in Mortal Instruments. That movie was a decent movie, but his performance, yet again, just shows you he does have a good range. And with Nightcrawler, I think you need to find an actor who's just a little bit off, you know what I mean? Who's just a little crazy, a little out there. And Robert fits the bill absolutely perfectly. I mean, really good actors are strange in general. There's that. So, I mean, if he takes that kind of approach to Nightcrawler in a way where he's a very interesting, unique person, he's not a person, no one's blue, he could take this character in a little bit more in-depth way than Alan Cummings did. Now, Alan did a fantastic job. I mean, he's been my favorite actor to play Nightcrawler. Robert, my friend, just keep that Klaus energy going, because you could find yourself in the blue paint in the MCU. Next up, we got Menda Messound. Now, Menda is best known for playing Aladdin in the live-action Aladdin movie with Will Smith. He was an okay genie. Now, the reason why I put him on this list is because I think he's an actor who hasn't really tapped into his potential yet, you know what I mean? He was very charismatic as Aladdin, and I believed him as Aladdin. I enjoyed that character. I think he needs to find a role that kind of gives him, yet again, a little bit more complex story, an accent to kind of show his range, that he can do other things. And I just feel like giving him something like this, where he can develop his own personality within this really weird mutant would fit perfectly. I mean, he's still an up-and-comer in Hollywood. He hasn't really done much. He has a couple of credits to his name, but he needs something like this, a big blockbuster franchise to actually get his career going a little bit more than he, you know, would suggest. I mean, I know Aladdin isn't that complex of a character. Anyone can play a street rat, riff-raff. They don't buy that. But now I got you singing the song, don't I? Now, this actor is a wild card on this list. I just feel like, you know, there are a lot of really talented actors out there. Some that just, you know, they're on the cusp of being the next Tom Holland. Do you know what I mean? And I think giving him something a little bit more complex would work perfectly. Will other people see it my way? I don't know. That's why we're here. So dust off that magic carpet there, Benda. You are now going to be in the MCU. Next up is an actor who is on, everyone's radar as of late, Timothy Chalamet. I said his last name wrong. I do that. If you've seen my episodes, you know I can't pronounce names, so we'll just go with that. Timothy. Now, Timothy is an amazing actor. If you haven't caught some of his movies that he's done, I mean, the man is progressing like Robert Pattinson. His career is growing and he's making really good choices when it comes to characters and projects. From the amazing Netflix movie with Robert Pattinson in The King, to the upcoming 2021 remake of Dune, this kid is all over the place. And a little side note, he has been rumored to play Terry McGinnis in the Batman Beyond movie that has been in development hell, but you know, that's another episode for another day. Now, Timothy always delivers in his performance. You believe him when he's angry, when he's sad, when he's charming, and he physically looks the part. What I mean by that is he's skinny. Now, that's no knock on his physical appearance, but Nightcrawler is fairly slender, you know what I mean? So I think physically he fits perfectly. Acting wise, he is one of my favorite actors on my list, just because, yet again, his performance and his craft gets better and better with each performance. So Timothy, when you're done with Dune, dust off all the sand, make your way over to Marvel and Atlanta, because you know that's where they film all the Marvel movies, and let's get you in the suit. Let's get you in the paint. Let's do it. Who can I call? And talking about A-list actors who are on top of their game, this actor has won an Academy Award. We're talking about Rami Malek. Now, Rami is one of those actors who is off screen, he's very odd. And rewind to what I said about Nightcrawler, I want to cast actors who are kind of a little different. The man, from his amazing transformation into Freddie Mercury to now playing the main villain in the latest James Bond movie, the man can do literally anything. Or if Nightcrawler had to, I don't know, dress up like Freddie Mercury to get into a building, he can do that. His unique voice and like his mannerisms are just so interesting that I think they lend themselves to like these little quirks that could make the character just a little bit more quirky. Yeah, that's the only word I can think of. Also, like Timothy, he is a very sought-after actor in Hollywood. There's no secret as to why. I mean, Mr. Robot, there's so many projects that he's done that you can look back and put him into any role, essentially, and he can take that role and just really make it just weird, but it works. But Rami being a little bit older, he is the older actor on this list. I think with all those tangibles that he has, he could bring a very unique take and spin off of this legendary poofing character. But guys, that's it. Did you agree with who I picked as Nightcrawler? If you did, let me know in the comments below. And if you didn't, let me know in the comments below. I truly appreciate everyone that has followed and continuing to just show me love with all the comments. I appreciate it. Keep commenting. Spread the love of my channel. I would greatly appreciate it. And I'm gonna leave you with a joke. So I recently found out that I can't read Charlie Brown comics anymore. Yeah, it's really depressing. Turns out I'm allergic to peanuts.